Welcome. What I'd like to do is talk about the Pythagorean triples and how we kind of use them in to help us solve problems that are given when we want to use the Pythagorean theorem. So what's helpful about the Pythagorean theorem, or Pythagorean triples, is each one of these numbers, where the largest number is always going to be the hypotenuse, when you apply the Pythagorean theorem, these create right triangles. So it's very helpful to know these numbers, because then if you see that the sides of a triangle are a Pythagorean triple, you actually don't have to do the Pythagorean theorem, because they've already been proven to work for the Pythagorean theorem, or to produce a right triangle. And what's also nice, these are like the most common that you'll probably see. So it's good to kind of have these memorized, because you can apply them later on. But what's also nice about these Pythagorean triples is they are still true by multiplying by any multiplier. Therefore, if I multiply this by 2, I would have 6, 8, 10. Well, guess what? 6, 8, 10 is also a Pythagorean triple. You could multiply these by 3, and it'd still produce a Pythagorean triple. So 15, 36, and you'd have 39. So if you multiply them by any multiplier, then the Pythagorean triple still works. So it's just very helpful to know these instead of having to do the Pythagorean theorem. And so let's go and look at a case like this. So here the case, I have my two legs, and I'm missing my hypotenuse as I go ahead and draw. So preferably, we'd probably plug them into one of our red equations, right? 5 squared plus 12 squared equals what squared? But we also notice that that is a Pythagorean triple. So 5 squared plus 12 squared is, guess what? It's going to equal 13 squared. So therefore, the value of my hypotenuse, in this case, I'll just use the Pythagorean triple, equals 13. Thanks.